In this Adobe Express tutorial, I'll show you how to customize a template and resize it for different platforms. So let's get started. Alright, this is the homepage. To find some templates, I'll go to the Explore tab. And here you can find a lot of different types of templates. Now I have a website here which is an e-commerce agency and I want to create a social media post for them. So I'll go back to the templates. And let's create an Instagram post. Click on View All to see more results. Let's see if we can find something. You can also use the search bar to look up for something specific. This one looks good. Click on this Customize button and it's gonna open up that template with all its layers. Before we proceed further with the customization, if you haven't watched the previous part, then I highly recommend checking that out first to catch up on the basics. Alright, I have the logo of the company that I'm gonna simply drag and drop here. I'll place it here, scale it down, and adjust it right on top of it. I'll lock the logo layer so that it don't move. Next, I'll select the previous logo that is behind it. It's also selecting this background layer which I don't want. So I'll select the background layer separately and hit delete. I'll select the previous logo layers, move it so you can see what's going on, and hit delete. Now the logo is not very visible on this background color, so I'll click here and change the background color to this gray color. I'll change the website URL. Also change this call to action text. I'll also change the main heading. Let's say we create e-commerce websites. I'll reduce the font size and reposition it. Let's make this even more smaller to create some contrast. I'll increase the line spacing. And adjust these patterns so that it aligns with the text. If you take a look on the actual website, you'll notice a seamless background in here. So I have that background image that I'm gonna import. And set it as page background so that it matches with the branding of the original company. Now the text isn't visible with this background. And I have the color codes of the brand that I'm gonna apply to the text and the other design elements. I'll also change this call to action background color. I'll decrease the corner roundness. And change the text color as well. I'll delete this element because it doesn't fit with the branding. Next, I'll change the color of this rectangle. And adjust it a little bit. That's it. Now to replace an image, click on this button. Then you can either upload your own image or choose one from the library. You can also use the search bar. Let's try this image. I'm gonna double click to open the crop tool and readjust the cropped area. That's it. I'll move this text layer above the image layer. Now I'm gonna create an effect with this image. I'll duplicate this image. Move the duplicate to the side so you can see it. Bring it to the front. Then I'm gonna remove its background. Next, I'll place it right on top of it. Move its layer with the other image layer. Now we have two images, one with the background and the other without it. I'm gonna select both the images and group them together from this button. I'll select the image layer which still has the background. Double click to open the crop tool and readjust the cropped area to create an effect like this. I'll scale it up and move its layers to the top. Maybe scale it even more. I'll reduce this text size. I'll reposition this design element and this one as well. I have a design element here which is not visible, so I'll change its color. There's another tip for you. If I select a layer and then click outside, then it's gonna hide the sidebar, so it'll disturb you moving back and forth while you're working. The solution to this is that you need to click on any of the sidebar menu before you select any layer, and you need to do this only once. Now when I select a layer and click outside, this page is gonna stay at the same place. So that's a very helpful trick. Alright, we have customized this design and it's looking pretty good. You can put your service name here, but I'm gonna keep it as it is. Now this design is ready, and let's say we want to create an Instagram story following this exact design. So what you can do is go to the resize button and then select your required size from here. If you click on resize, then it's going to resize the current page. But if you click on duplicate and resize, then it'll create a new page. Double click to open it. This is the new Instagram story size page. You can see that it has automatically scaled our background image. Now we need to adjust and reposition layers so it can fit the page. I'll unlock the logo layer and move it to the top. Move this text as well and scale it up. Next, I'll select these elements and move them to the bottom. Let's move the image group to the bottom and scale it up. Some text here is not visible, so I'll move its layers to the front. I'll increase its font size and adjust the image a little bit. I'll reposition the logo so that it aligns with the overall design. Next, I'll move the services text and scale it up. I'll change the composition of these elements as we have some more space available. I'll place the call to action here and scale it up so that it's more prominent. I'll move the website address right below it. I'll scale it up, and this one as well. I'll actually delete this rectangle, duplicate this line, and place it right here. That looks better. Next, I'll select these elements and reposition so that it makes more sense. Just give it some breathing space. I'll scale up the logo. You can place some information here if you want. I'll adjust it a little bit. That looks good. And here's our design, resized for an Instagram story. Now let's move one step further and create a flyer with this design. Duplicate and resize. And there it is. Now I'm gonna repeat the same process here. We already have the information properly placed and the composition ready. All I'm gonna do is adjust all these layers a little bit, tweak them where needed, and place them in a way that makes more sense. So with a platform like Adobe Express, it becomes very easy to convert one design into multiple sizes while keeping a consistent design. Alright, this is our fly design. This is an Instagram story. And this is a social media post, all following a consistent design. You can download your files from here, select your required format, and then download. Now, I've done it very quickly just for the demonstration, but you can really take your time to make a great design using these templates. I hope this video was helpful. Please give it a like and subscribe so I can keep on making more videos for you. In the next part, I'll show you how to create markups in Adobe Express. You can find the video link on the screen right now. I'll see you there. Take care.